and my wheels are massive. My friends assassins, all of us. Our mothers queens and our women dancers. My river's rapping, my fin is splashing, my gills are flapping. I bit some matches and sip some too and kiss the dragon.
I'm really rapping, no finger snapping, them packing. Y'all slipping, my swag is dripping, so here's a napkin. What's really happening, verbal attacking, I'm showing passion. Know what I mean, see I'm the king like I'm from Akron. I'm going overboard, somebody call the captain. And when it come to getting checks, I always want the fat ones. I'm so I can sing to a chandelier.
Hello everyone, I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. We're across the pond in England this week, and two teams are hoping to show up for an international audience. It's the Titans going up against the Bulldogs. So with kickoff approaching, let's send it over to our commentators here this afternoon, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, we appreciate it, Larry. It's our exclusive coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. Coming up, another edition of the NFL International Series, and it should be a good one. Between the Tennessee Titans, there he goes, what? And he takes it all the way, but there is a flag down, so hold the celebration. This one's coming back. And the London Bulldogs. And that right there is how you silence the home crowd.
All week long in preparation, visiting teams talk about it. Okay, we've got to start fast. We've got to take the crowd out of it, as you just talked about there. We've got to control the ball early. And in this case, forget fast start. This is a blazing start. What they've talked about all week is their offensive unit doing that. Not necessarily the guys returning the opening kickoff, but believe me, they'll take this.
And a lot of the weight of this offense falls on the shoulders of the running back.
That's because the offense knows if they give him any openings, any opportunities, he could turn it into a big play at any time.
On second down, here's Manning. Out on the right, this is Cruz. And oh, right away, he lost the football. And this will be scooped up by the defense. And he's going to bring the fumble back for a touchdown. The pass receiver turned into a runner, then he turned into a fumbler, and it goes the other way for six.
I love your description. Although for the offense, they're not too happy about it. But for the defense, what a big-time play for them. Never give up on anything. Sometimes you create your own points.
But the receiver, hard to fault him. He's just going for extra yards.
That's exactly what you're supposed to do, but you have to take care of the football.
So here's the kickoff now as they'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. Set to return. Here's Raheem Mostert. Oh, look at the juke. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. Now here's the first carry for DeMarco Murray. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. A gain of three, second down.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
Now Manning throwing on second down. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Carlos Dunlap in there yet again. What else is new as he continues to rewrite the record book in single season sacks. Third down, still 14 yards left. On third and long, it's Manning. Complete to the tight end, Jason Morrow. It'll be a pickup of 14, but they're still a little bit short as it brings up fourth.
Almost not fair. The big guy running the corner route, being able to lean and push and get to where he wants.
So how do you stop it?
A lot of times you want to have a linebacker on him, a bigger body guy who can handle him physically. But a lot of times that doesn't work as well because his quickness often wins the route.
And they'll play keep away from the returner as this one will be marked out of bounds at the 13-yard line. Pretty good spot.
Thank you.
Now Dalton with a first and 10. He completes it to Julio Jones. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
That was not a completion that results in a highlight video. But at the same time, if you have those kind of completions all game long, eventually one of them might turn into a highlight.
Second and very short here, less than a yard. Now a first carry for Giovanni Bernard. And down he'll go at the 25. Only 3 there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains.
It's really simple to say that they know their identity, that they are a passing team. But one of the reasons they're so successful, they know how to mix in the run and make sure that
Julio Jones all alone. Touchdown! Julio Jones, 74 yards. And his guys find a way to stretch that lead.
I think if you pulled defensive backs, they would say the corner route, take that out, make it illegal, because that is so hard to recognize and so hard to adjust, because your first move is to not get beat in the middle of the field. And that's how they move you first before they break off to the corner.
But then as a wide receiver, great job. It's tough to turn those upfield and go, but he did a great job with it there.
Really good balance, really good body control. And how about the end result? A touchdown.
This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. And a nice job there as he gets this one up just shy of the 35-yard line at the 34. Out come the Titans now. And still no points on the scoreboard. You're coming off of the 3-and-out. They're just looking for anything to grab onto right now, aren't they?
I'm wondering if someone's going to take charge in the huddle. You know, we always look to the quarterback, but sometimes it's another player on the team.
And he's hit and taken down. Eli sacked. Michael Johnson, he's the one to get him, and that's sack number 7 for him on the year. Manning to throw on second down, and he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. And we take a look at the starting lineup defensively.
Geno Atkins is an absolute force as a defensive tackle, forces every offense that he plays against to alter their game plan.
The wide receiver moving to a new spot. From the gun on third down, Manning. Looking to hit Matthews, but it's intercepted. Picked off by the Alabama man, Dre Kirkpatrick. And he's able to get it back to the 33-yard line. Now this offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you
now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Their D gets the INT. Now what can Dalton do? The left side completion to Jones. And all the way in for the touchdown. Julio Jones with his second touchdown of this opening quarter. And his guys are going to add on to their lead. And we'll see if this rain affects the team's decisions going forward. But they kick it here, and it's good. After the touchdown, here's Mike Nugent now to kick this one away. This one taken just inside the 10. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. The Titan offense now working their way back onto the field. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
They fake the handoff. Now Manning. Rashard Matthews here on the catch. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving. So there on that play, offensively, they ran the crossing route. Defense was in zone coverage, so as a former DB, how tough is it to defend that?
It's really difficult because your natural inclination is to chase the receiver and maybe leave your zone. So you have to have discipline in order to talk to your other coverage guys and let them know that that receiver's crossing from your zone to the next zone. He's coming your way. Make sure you have him. And then when the ball is actually thrown, secure the tackle. When they're moving on crossing routes, if you miss a tackle, it usually results in a big play.
And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line.
In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they could do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver, but to have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks, those guys are worth their weight in gold.
On second down, here's Manning. And he's got his man in stride, complete. Touchdown! Titans. Victor Cruz, his second touchdown on the season. And the Titans are able to cut into that deficit. And that will cut this lead down to 13. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Out comes this offensive unit as they get set to take over here. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful you're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz scheme, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. They come up in an empty set, four wide receivers, one tight end. So Dalton now, Wright's got it. And he showcases the spin, a pretty good gain before he's taken down. It's an 8-yard pickup, and it's a second down. Another chance for Dalton. He completes it to Jones, and he's brought down. 16 yards to the 16 and a first down. Sitting alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon as it's London football to begin quarter number two. And they're on the move here. They've got it first and 10. Incomplete. Boy, he doesn't drop many like that one. Second down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away, but the bottom line is that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Second down now after the incompletion. Passing again, Dalton on second and 10. This will be caught at about the 3. And he gets into the end zone for the touchdown. Tyler Eifert, his second touchdown on the season. And his guys find a way to stretch that lead. After the touchdown, here's Mike Nugent now to kick this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. And they're going to need another score. Got one last time, but still down here.
When you're playing catch-up, every possession becomes crucial, doesn't it? It's vital. Get back out on the field, punch in the end zone again. They know it's not easy, but what they do have going for them, they did score the last time. They think they've got a good formula working.
And what about the defense?
Well, now you're just saying to yourself, okay, gave up a score last time. What adjustments do we need to make to slow them down now and get the ball back for our own offense? Is it more pressure? Is it more zone? What do they have to do? They're trying to figure that out themselves.
We'll see if they can figure that out right here. A gain of 6 there on first.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
From midfield, here's Manning. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. And the offense looks to pick up the first here on third after that incompletion. Walker, the tight end, in motion. Manning to throw once more. He's got Cruz complete. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first.
I feel like Eli Manning has just gone from downfield bomber to a guy who can complete everything.
He can hit him underneath now.
Yeah, we just saw that there with that pass completion. The maturity of a veteran taken with the defense will give him.
Throwing on first down is Manning. He's going to air it out deep for Matthews. And almost intercepted. It would have been his second pick of the game. Instead, it'll be second down.
The name of the game, as always on defense, put pressure on the quarterback. And that's exactly what they've done today. It looks like they've got him a little bit rattled. That would have been the second interception in the first half.
Now a play fake. Manning steps away to his left. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. Defense has set themselves up nicely. Third and 10 now. Throwing is Manning on third down. A hit as he throws there, incomplete. Rashard Matthews, the intended target, and that brings up fourth down. Here's Brett Kern now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. And this will be out of bounds at the what here? The 12-yard line. And here now the offense heading back out there. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
And with that completion, he's now north of 200 yards here in the first half. Boy, a tough start for the secondary defensively.
It is, and it's got to put a dent in their confidence. And, you know, you always want to keep that up and feel like you can always bounce back after plays. But with the kind of numbers he's putting up here, it's starting to wear on them a little bit, I think. So they're looking at each other and trying to figure out what defense will work and how can they play better without getting beat deep for big passes.
They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Dalton throwing on second down. Complete to Rice. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs. Andy Dalton. And now with that completion, he's north of 200 yards here in the first half.
And he's going to break our statistician, Marvin, isn't he? Marvin right now is just tallying it up. Hope his hand doesn't hurt too much doing this or keeps hitting the calculator. But my goodness, what a start he is off to. By the end of this game, he could have monster numbers. He just wants to continue to be accurate.
Field here, Dalton, and he rifles one incomplete. So oftentimes you see defensive holding here, it's offensive holding for the flag. Dalton again. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion.
A nickel set shown by the Titans on third down.
Thinking pass. Fakes the give to Bernard. Dalton, he's got time. He'll rifle this one deep right side. The Pro Bowl wideout Julio Jones is intended receiver. And that brings up fourth down. So on fourth down, Britton Colquitt on to punt. And not what he was hoping for there, as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. The Titans offense now, they work their way back onto the field. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. He had time, was able to survey the field and find a soft spot in that zone coverage.
And that's where it gets difficult for a defender, Brandon. You go to your spots on the field that you have to.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Carlos Dunlap in there to pick up his second sack now of the afternoon. And they'll be in search of 11 yards here on third down. Manning. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. So quick on the spin.
He's spinning, man.
8 yards on the screen there, not enough. And it'll be fourth down.
I wonder what was going through his mind when he got the play call. He just got sacked on the previous play. He knows they're coming after him again. A little bit of guts to stand in there, take the hit, and successfully complete the screen pass. Really well done.
He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Taking it about the 36. That'll go as a punt of 34 yards that time. And out will come the offense as they take over. Now this offense ready to head back out there. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage.
Leverage.
Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer, create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and get these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. And it looks like this will likely be the last play before we hit the two-minute warning.
Let's see if they can sneak one more good play in before the two-minute signal.
The play clock's running down. So Dalton now to the left side here for Eifert. 1:57 to go in this first half. Back to the booth right after this. Offense comes to the line now, 1st and 10. Came at one. Now here's Dalton. Underneath, this is Bernard. And he'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. 11 yards on the pickup, and it's good enough for a first down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Oh, he's able to out-muscle him here as he pulls it in. It's a good gain of 11, sets him up 1st and goal. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Now Dalton, and he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Another look for Dalton on second and 10. And that'll be incomplete. An extra defensive back on the field here for third and goal. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. And he will take this one in for a touchdown. Jamison Crowder, his fourth touchdown on the year. And his guys are going to add on to their lead. And he knocks it through. After the touchdown, here's Mike Nugent now to kick this one away. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
Check. They've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before and realize it hasn't worked.
Go to something else.
And maybe you try.
And he's hit and taken down. Eli sacked. Michael Johnson. He's the one to get him, and that's sack number 7 for him on the year. Manning the throw on second down. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Well, the pressure, the hits, the sacks have been coming at him all game long. I'm frankly surprised that they haven't found a solution yet to create more time for him to throw it or maybe change what they do on offense.
Yeah, that's one of the biggest differences in this game and why they're losing right now. Third and long, it's Manning backing up. All kinds of time. He sets to fire deep. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
They decided to air it out a little bit on that play, take a shot downfield, but the coverage was really nice. Able to get a hand in and tip it away.
They'll score that a 36-yard punt, and the offense will take over with a new set of downs. So out now comes the offense back onto the field. Good drive last time, really effective passing the football. Do you maybe mix it up, now go to the ground game and surprise the defense a little bit? Looking for Jones, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Mike Mitchell, and they have the football and will set up shop at the 33-yard line. And here comes Tennessee as they get sent to take the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Well, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here.
There are a good number of coaches that anytime they call an in route are really worried about the play because there's so much traffic ordinarily that the ball has to get through to get to the receiver. And on that play, it was batted down.
Manning again here on second and 10. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. On third down, Murray. No gain on the play there. A nice job defensively. And it likely forces a punt situation on fourth.
I have to admit to a little surprise here. A net down in distance, I would have thought they were going to throw the football. Instead, they decide to run it. But give credit to the defense. They weren't fooled at all and held them to no gain.
And that one didn't accomplish a whole lot. It'll be down inside the 35-yard line. And now back out comes the offense. And with great field position here, chance for some points before the break.
That's prime real estate. Just have to decide how they want to try and take their shot to try and put those points on the board.
Really nice starting field position here for the offensive unit. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half. The final act of the first half, Dalton, deep drop. He'll rifle this, and it's caught. Touchdown, Julio Jones, as time expires in the first half. And this offense continues to pour it on.
Did I just see all of that happen? Did I just see the pass, the catch in the end zone for a touchdown, the clock go to zeros? All we've got now is the PAT left before we end a really good half.
Yeah, that's something to take into the lockers. A little momentum to build on for sure.
And what I want you to watch is the team that kicks the PAT as we expect it to go through the post. Watch how quickly they head to the locker room. They'll be the ones that have the momentum, and they'll be flying.
And he nearly broke that for more. But as it is, they'll start this drive at about the 37-yard line. Now Dalton with a first and 10. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete. He was looking for Jamison Crowder there. And now it's second down. So the numbers have been good in the passing game, and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot. But they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall.
Zebra! Zebra!
Second and 10, Dalton once more. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. A very solid gain of 27. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve.
Hey, blue, 10. Jagger, Jagger.
Dalton, first and 10. Underneath, this is Bernard. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and that'll bring up second down.
Now, that's the type of play that gives you a chance to win. Nothing forced downfield where you don't have a guy open. Swing it out to the back, on maybe even check it down, whatever you want to call it. Gain of 5. You're just trying to get 4 on first down. They're ahead of the chains now.
Dalton. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. So incomplete on second down. Now they'll look to convert here on third. This will be Dalton again. Got a man. It's right. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains.
That looked like a pretty good route combination there, because you've got to find a way to clear the guy running the drag. Because when you do, you can just put the ball on him and then let him run.
Yeah, he's got some space. No gain there on the completion. Second and 10.
Brandon, just mark that under the category of just not successful. Trying to throw the ball, just didn't work on that one.
Completed it. No yardage. Another chance for Dalton. And he finds a man on the crossing route. And he's brought down. And the play goes for 19 yards. Gives him a new set of downs. Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. They come out 5 wide. 3 of them to the right side. Here's Dalton. And oh my goodness, what a catch at the 6. It's a good gain of 11. Sets him up first and goal. Just a heck of a catch. How does he make that play?
I wish I knew, and I wish I had his athleticism, because his ability to go up and contort his body in so many ways and still come down with the catch, phenomenal.
And he will take it in for the touchdown. Julio Jones from 4 yards out. And this offense is running away with this one. And let's count them up now. 1, 2, 3, 4 touchdown receptions for him in this game.
And just one shy of the NFL record. What a great performance. Going up and catching the football, creating space, and finding the end zone. That's what it's all about.
And after the touchdown, here's Mike Nugent now to kick this one away. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know, at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10. Kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, just something to get you off to a quick start.
Murray, the lone setback. He'll get the football here. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. The linebacker, Junior Gallette, in on the stop.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
And he locates Walker, complete. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs.
And the game just keeps evolving. Big guys running those corner routes, so difficult to cover.
Manning now on first down. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete.
Timing is crucial in any route thrown, but when you throw an out, so many things are going through the mind of the receiver. Catching the ball, timing it up with the quarterback. Are my feet going to get down inbounds? On that play, all those things going through his head might have caused him to drop it.
Manning will try again on second down. Over the middle, and it's incomplete. Rashard Matthews, the intended target, and now it's third down.
Whenever they're trying to attack a zone defense, you're trying to figure out where your gaps are going to be. And depending on what type of zone they're playing, it could be on the outside, it could be in the middle, it could be in the seams, in the edges. In this case, they tried to attack the middle of the field, but this zone defense didn't allow it because they were able to see the ball come off the quarterback's hands, and everyone was able to react to the football and knock it away.
And he's got the first down yardage there as he takes it just across midfield.
Let's give a little credit there. The offensive play caller sense that the screen pass was available. Whenever you're getting a lot of heavy pressure towards your quarterback, that's when you're thinking about running the screen and using that pressure against the defense. And it worked very well there for a first down.
Throwing on first down is Manning. And that'll be incomplete. Matthews, the intended target, and it's second down.
It appears that the pressure is affecting him today. Normally, he knows exactly when to get rid of the football, but today, because he's been hit a few times, he's getting rid of it a little bit too quickly.
To throw is Manning. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. Touchdown, Titans. DeMarco Murray with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Titans are able to at least knock this deficit down a bit. So they get one score back, but still a long ways to go here in this third quarter. There's the Titan kick team as they run up and send this one away. And the kickoff sails out of bounds, and that's going to be a penalty.
You can see the looks on the faces of the rest of the team. You have one job to do. Just kick the ball and play.
Well, that's exactly right, Charles. The kicker, this is just inexcusable.
Absolutely inexcusable. Everyone out there slugging it out for the entire game. Execute your job.
The first down throw coming for Dalton. To the left side here for Eifert. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. And on that last play there, he's over 400 yards passing now.
You know what that generally means?
Success.
That, and it means you really didn't miss opportunities. Usually very accurate. The ball's getting to the right place. Guys are making yardage after the catch to help you out that way. I mean, the whole team has picked it up. And don't forget, that means the offensive line has had to pass protect pretty well, too.
Everyone dialed in. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. And now he's closing in on 450 yards passing.
That's an incredible number. I mean, you're talking about the best defenders in the world that you're trying to throw the ball against, and you're creating that type of a number. Fantastic job, fantastic performance. And he's going to have to ice up his arm afterwards, too.
And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will absolutely break your heart. They had everything they wanted, just unable to complete it in the end zone, a big-time drop.
They come up in an empty set. Four wide receivers, one tight end. Passing, it's Dalton. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield. Let's face it, perfection is something we all chase, whether it's playing this game or whatever we do. Hard to attain, but that's what they were searching for as that pass goes incomplete.
So it looks like the offense isn't going anywhere. They're going to go for it on 4th and 7. They'll try to pass on 4th down. Dalton on the screen. Bernard. Mike Tomlin takes a shot here, but to no avail. And it'll be a turnover on downs. Here's the Titan offense now as they make their way back onto the field. Last time they were out, they scored. Still trailing here, though, so some work to do.
But it's okay in terms of mindset. Because they scored the last time, they're not quite as worried about being down on the scoreboard because now their confidence is a little bit higher. They feel like they've got something going, and they feel like they can attack again.
Off to the races, DeMarco Murray. He's at the 40, the 20. Touchdown, Titans. DeMarco Murray, 95 yards. And the Titans are able to strike for 6. And that run massively increased his production in this game, and now he's over 100 yards.
And break out your calculator, partner, because his yards per carry went up significantly, right? Big-time jaunt all the way to the end zone.
This one taken just inside the 10. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. Now this offense ready to take over again. And on the last drive, they were in field goal range. They just opted not to kick it, didn't get it. How does that change the mentality this go around?
I don't think it changes much for the head coach because this is what he preaches all the time. Attack at all times in any spot on the field. And he likes touchdowns, not field goals. Now, your field goal kicker, you've got to make sure you nurse him through and say, okay, don't worry about it. When we need you, you've got to be ready to go. And the team, of course, loves to see points on the board. So let's see if it changes a little bit if they're in the same spot again.
Yeah, we'll see what the decision is here if they get to that spot. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
Looked like they had an opportunity for a big play across the middle, but he didn't have the concentration or the focus necessary and dropped it before he could haul it in.
So the incomplete pass brings up 2nd down. Passing again, Dalton on 2nd and 10. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. Touchdown! Julio Jones, 76 yards. And this offense continues to pour it on. And that touchdown reception is the fifth for him in this game, and that ties the NFL record.
And a record that's held up since 1950. This is another person that's tied it, but think about this. Bob Shaw said it in 1950. Kellen Winslow came along and tied it. And then, of course, Jerry Rice tied it as well. And finally, we're seeing it here one more time. Phenomenal.
After the touchdown, here's Mike Nugent now to kick this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. And coming off a one-play drive that was so deflating for the defense, what's their mentality? How do they rally here and stop this offense?
Well, hopefully there's some determination that sets in, because they weren't ready to go on the last one. Give all the credit to the offensive guys for getting it done, but to allow a run of that length, that's just not being prepared. So now, are they determined? Are they ready to read their keys and make the proper plays?
And we'll see how determined they are. Welcome back now here in London. And this is a blowout so far as we get set for the fourth quarter. A very one-sided affair. Throwing on second down, and he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
When defenses get to the quarterback that quickly, a lot of times it's called a jailbreak. It wasn't quite that fast, but fast enough that he had no time to look downfield and set himself to throw the ball, and as he tried to do that, he was hit, and it forced an incompletion.
Offense in a little bit of a bind here. 9 yards to go on third down. Handoff. It's Murray. Oh, little 360. Just a 1 yard pickup there, and it'll be fourth down. Here's Brett Kern now, as they're forced to kick for the sixth time today. And this is a beauty as that ball's going to angle out at the 6 yard line. Now, this offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch counter punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got to a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
We'll see if they dial it up this drive. Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. Play clock winding down. Second and 10. Dalton once more. Complete to right. Whoosh. And they'll get him down up past the 15, just shy of the 20. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
First and 10 for Dalton. Crowder's got it over the middle. Give him 22 on that one. And that'll be good enough for the first. And a nice pitch and catch to pick up the reception against man coverage.
Both of them read how much yardage they needed, figured what they had to do, and were able to beat the man coverage for the completion.
And a double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off, William Gay. And they will set up shop at their own 46-yard line. And here comes Tennessee as they get sent to take the field. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut him, all right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But hey, listen, there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
10 yards on the pickup there, and the Titans are going to have a first.
And after that completion, you can understand why so many teams in the league are emphasizing speed on defense at every position. The tight ends have created so many tough matchups now. If you can't run with a tight end as a linebacker, this is going to be the result every time.
And quickly, they get to the line. Murray, the lone setback. Here's Manning to throw. He's going to sling this deep downfield, and he can't hang on. That's definitely going to be one he wishes he had back. Incomplete in the end zone.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
Now Manning on the bootleg. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. The defense rising to the challenge and setting him back on the sack. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
Oh, he'll field it in the end zone. So a change of possession here on the punt. And this offense is going to take over at their own 20-yard line. Out comes this offensive unit as they get set to take over here. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they... And he's going to be intercepted a third time. A great read, and it's picked off. And the Titans getting set to go. And last time out, they had to punt the football away. Anything positive possibly to take from that?
There always is when you're punting the football away. It doesn't sound like it because you're giving it up, but you've avoided a mistake.
At least you didn't turn it over.
You didn't turn it over, right? You're giving it, you're giving your defense a chance because you're punting the ball away, and they're set to go on the field as opposed to sudden change after a turnover. Wow, now we got to go out there and stop people. So, yeah, there's always something positive to be gained from it.
Second down following the run. Manning to throw on second down. Looking for Cruz, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the Alabama man, Dre Kirkpatrick.
Well, you're trailing. It's the fourth quarter, and you've got to throw the football. But the defense knows this, too. So they're just going to sit back, bring in an extra defensive back or two, the old nickel or dime strategy, Brandon, and wait for you to put that bad boy up for grabs. And this one winds up being intercepted.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. And never good on a pass completion there to go the wrong way. Lost yardage.
No, for some reason, it seems to work better when you throw it downfield or you can move the ball downfield running it that way, doesn't it? But in this case, if you're the defensive guys, you're energized, executed well, and you caused a lost yardage play. That's going to feel good and look great in film.
And that one almost intercepted. Far too loose with the football here. Nearly a fourth pick. And it's third down. Third down, a shot here for Dalton. Now he's hit, and Dalton lost the football. The big man, get the oxygen tank ready. Oh, he tried to pitch it, and the ball's loose. And that might be Titan football. It is. And here comes Tennessee as they get sent to take the field. And they had a nice little drive going last time. Threw the interception in the red zone. Costly.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we've got a shot at points already. We're already in a spot where you're thinking you've got three on the board for sure, and to come away with nothing, that's a really tough one for them to swallow.
Yeah, will they make up for it? Now they'll run, Murray, and he's going to get this back to the three-yard line and no further. Calling a gain of a yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's third and goal. Time for a break. This one, all over but the shouting. We'll finish it after this. From the 3-yard line once more. Now here's third and goal. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. The big fella. And he cuts it back right, and he's got a crease. And the return stops at the 39-yard line. And here now the offense heading back out there. They have the big lead here late. They protected their home turf well, didn't they?
They certainly did, partner. And just think about how good that feels, because every team has a goal when they start.
And this will be caught. And the carnage continues. It's another touchdown.
Well, this game is definitely over, but we do know some people like to go ahead and continue to add to their score, don't we?
Yeah, I don't know that they need to add any more right now, though. I'm just starting to think about those dinner plans tonight, my friend.
Well, you and I will be thinking about dinner plans, but we also know that plenty of people are thinking, how can I get some more scores for my fantasy, forever, other things? They're trying to figure that part out now.
By the way, last weekend we went sushi because that's what you wanted. We're going steak tonight.
I'm in.
All right. The Titans offense now, they get ready to do battle again here. They are just obviously getting shellacked here in this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach for this final drive in a lopsided game like this?
For a lot of coaches,
be honest,
don't forget today. Don't forget what has happened out here.
Yeah, use that as ammo
exactly.
Going forward.
Exactly. Take a great look at that scoreboard. Realize how poorly everything went for us today. Coaching, playing, the whole deal.
Now, defensively here, we're going to get a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Keep it on the ground, but this time it's Murray. And not a whole lot doing there, as he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. It's a gain of maybe 3, but it's going to leave him with still about 8 or 9 to go on third down. Nine yards to go. It's third down. Murray, the lone setback. Throwing is Manning on third down. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. Here's Brett Kern now as he's on to punt for Tennessee. He'll return it from the 6. A great return there of 22 yards. And possession will switch hands, 1st and 10. Now this offense ready to head back out there. They can now enjoy the final stages of this one. A very convincing win. I don't know what was said in the locker room, but whatever it was, it worked pretty well.
It certainly did, and it's probably a capper to everything that was said during the week, because they go over every eventuality. I mean, you know how coaches are. They want to cover every minute detail, all the way up to how much time does it take to walk from the locker room to the field, you name it. And when it all comes together and results in a victory, everyone feels pretty good about that.
Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about. Extra point coming now for Nugent. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. And after the touchdown, here's Mike Nugent now to kick this one away. This is taken just shy of the 10 here. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
That's all that's left, because victory, not a chance now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it, because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guys on the field now, and if they call plays they want executed, they need to do that and do it really well. Otherwise, there could be repercussions.
We'll see how they handle the waning moments of this one. One final try now for Manning. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And a little bit of a consolation prize there. He's into the end zone. Won't win him the game, but they do get the score with all zeros showing.
But some fantasy players are really happy with that score. Well, I do have one word for that touchdown for you, partner. You ready?
Yeah.
Cosmic.